Hello, and welcome to this video tutorial on getting started with Easy Interactive Tools, the free software application that comes with your BrightLink interactive display. Your BrightLink interactive display can be used both with or without a PC. When used without a PC, it will function as a digital dry erase board. Simply power it on. When the home screen appears, you will see a whiteboard icon. Select it with the interactive pen or finger if your BrightLink is touch-enabled. An important distinction between PC-free interactive and PC interactive is the ability to interact with content and or save your work. Although PC-free does allow you to save content, you must have your BrightLink connected to a network or use the optional USB cable to save to a flash drive in order to save content. While PC-free is a convenient and useful tool for impromptu whiteboarding, using BrightLink while attached to a PC is where you find the greatest amount of utility. Attaching to a PC allows you to use BrightLink as an extension of your PC, providing full access to your applications, files, web browser, as well as favorite curriculum sites and tools. To use with your PC, you connect your PC to the BrightLink with a video cable for display and USB cable for interactivity. Easy Interactive Tools, or EIT as we refer to it, allows you to interact with the PC content you are displaying on your BrightLink projector. EIT also has a digital whiteboard component that works like a dry erase board. It is a whiteboard canvas where you can draw, erase, insert images, add and delete pages, and create reusable lesson plans that can be saved to your computer. If you do not already have a copy of Easy Interactive Tools, you can download it from the support page of your BrightLink model, which can be found at epson.com/support. Simply navigate to your model where you can download the file. After downloading, you can install the EIT program to your computer. However, in some cases, installation of software may be managed by your PC or network administrator, so be sure to contact them if this is your policy. Okay, with EIT installed on your computer, we are now ready to get started. As mentioned, EIT is designed to allow you to interact and control your computer from your BrightLink display. So before getting started, you need to connect the computer to the BrightLink. You can use an HDMI cable for audio and video and a USB cable for interactivity. Once connected, and with your BrightLink powered on, you can use your interactive pen to open the EIT application. I am using EIT version 5, which as of 2021 is the latest version of the EIT software. It is compatible with any of the BrightLink displays. And once the application opens, you will see the digital whiteboard. And located along the bottom of the whiteboard are a bunch of useful tools, including pen tools such as a black, red, green, yellow pens. You also have the ability to do a highlighter or select line thicknesses here. Beyond that is an eraser tool. And then over here on the right side is a text tool, which allows you to add a text box to the whiteboard canvas. So you can invoke the digital whiteboard keyboard and put text into the whiteboard space. Moving over to the left side of the tools, I have a camera icon. And so the camera icon allows me to do a screen grab of some content that I might have on my PC screen. I can capture the whole screen, or I can capture just a portion of the screen and import it into my whiteboard space. Next to that, I have my whiteboard tools. And there's a bunch of tools here in the toolbox. First, on the left side, they have to deal with doing file management. So you have the ability to open a new file, open an existing file. You can print. All of our Easy Interactive Tools settings are also contained here, and we'll talk about that a little bit later. And then if you want to open your most recent file, you can do that by selecting this icon. On the right-hand side, we have some tools for managing the whiteboard canvas itself, where if you have a document camera attached, such as we have here, you can access your document camera and show that content and import it into the whiteboard. You also have the ability to enlarge and zoom in and zoom out on content here. There's both a shade tool and a spotlight tool, which is useful for when you have content up there and you want to do a slow reveal, or if you want your audience to focus on a particular part of the content, you would control that with these tools here, the shade and the spotlight. And lastly, there's an on-screen keyboard. So when you touch this button, it invokes the keyboard, that the soft keyboard that's contained in Windows or Macintosh, and allows you to type onto the screen as well. All right, and to the left side of the whiteboard is where I have some tools for managing the content, the pages themselves. So I have several different things I can do over here. For one, there is a background icon. If I select the background icon, I see that I have a white page, a black page, or a green board page. And included in each one of these are a set of horizontal lines, vertical lines, and graphs. So if I want to set a page background, I can do so by simply clicking on here, and then you see how I've changed this to a grid. If you want to use some photographs or images on your computer that to set as a background, you can do that as well. So by using the top icon, I select here, I go and I find a file that I would like to show, and I hit open, and now my background becomes my photograph. So this is the background of the page. Then in the bottom left, I also have a page sorter. So this is where I can manage my pages. So as I add pages and I click on the add page button, you'll see it added a page 2, and that's added here. This is where I also have the ability to delete a page or add additional pages or copy. So that is the slide sorter function that is built into the whiteboard. Okay, returning to the whiteboard, we can take a look at some of the other tools that are available. First of all, as I mentioned, here's your whiteboarding tools down here, your annotation tools, erasers and such. You can move this about the canvas by just selecting the handle on the end. There's a handle on each side and it can be moved about the board. If you are ready to annotate, you can grab the pen tool down here, and I'm just going to select a pen. I can select my line thickness, and then I can select my color. So in this case, I have chosen a red pen. So similar to selecting the pen tools, I also have an eraser tool down here that I can select from. So if I want to erase part of the drawing, I can do so by using the eraser tool. Next, if I want to add a page, I can come over to the page sorter and I have the ability to add an additional page. In this case, I'm going to insert an object. And in order to do so, I'm going to come down here and I'm going to select a square. And I'm going to make it blue. So here, by dragging and dropping, I have my blue square that I've written onto the screen. If I want to make copies of that object, I grab my select tool, I touch the object, and then you'll see a drop down. If I select the drop down, I can copy and then drop down again, paste, and it places the second object onto the page. Again, if I want to add an additional page, I can hit the plus button, and now it's added a third page to my sort. So if I want to clone objects is something that you can do. So I can come over here and hit insert a file. In this case, I'm going to insert a penny. And so I have an image of a penny that comes up on my screen. And for example, I'm going to do a lesson on counting. So I can touch the object, I can select the drop down, and then select infinite cloning. Once I've done that, each time I touch the object, I can grab and drag onto the screen, and it's going to add additional objects. If I get to the point where I want to remove an object, I can simply select the drop down again, and I can hit delete, and it'll start removing these objects one by one. If I wish to clear the entire page, I can do so by selecting the trash can. I do that, it asks me if I want to confirm that I want to delete, I say yes, so now it clears the page. Here, if I want to change the order of my pages, I can select page number 2, I can drag it down here, and now it's moved it into the number 3 slot. If I want to remove a page, I can hit the X button, and remove that page, again, it's going to prompt me if I want to delete the page, and now the page is gone and I'm back to two pages. Next, if I have a document camera attached to my PC, I can use EIT to access the camera and import images into my whiteboard canvas. So the setup is simple. I have a DC-13 document camera from Epson. It's plugged into my PC with a USB cable. So once I come over to the whiteboard and access the whiteboard tools, the objects that are shown underneath the camera will display up on the large screen. So I come over, I select the toolbox icon, and from there I'm going to select camera. So at this point the camera is then accessed and turns on and shows the content that I have that's underneath the camera. I can use the built-in tools as part of EIT to insert to zoom in or zoom out on those objects that are underneath the camera. So I can do that like this. If I want to write out an equation of what I see represented here, I can grab the pen tool where I come up here and I can show that 3 + 6 = 9, right? So there I have an equation and the live objects that are underneath the camera. If I want to maximize the image so the kids at the back of the classroom can see easier, I can go to the full screen mode. And so now it takes up the majority of the screen with the image. At this point, if I want to, I could also do a capture of the camera. So, and that's going to import this object into the whiteboard canvas. And I do that by hitting the insert image. The camera took a shot of it. It placed it on a new page that is here. And here I have my dice with my equation. So if I grab the select tool, I can then select the object. I can move it about the whiteboard and I can resize the image as well. So there it is, just a simple way to use your Epson document camera with EIT and your BrightLink. And there you have it, a brief tour of the basic features of Easy Interactive Tools. In addition to this video, there is an EIT quick guide posted to the BrightLink support page, which gives a one-page summary of the EIT toolbar. I recommend that you print this out and keep it handy should you ever need some guidance. For more extensive information, you can download the EIT user's guide, which is also posted to the BrightLink support page where you downloaded the EIT software. Thanks so much for taking the time to view this video, and thank you for choosing Epson.